was a good amateur, but he's had his ups and downs. You know, he's learned about the business in his short career, and he's managed to win the British title. So he should be confident. He's coming off a career-best win in winning that title. So we expect to see him at his best.
Plenty of support, because he lives on the borders. And look how relaxed and happy he is. Likeable guy, and the fans are really, really looking forward to this. Let's have a look at the tail of the tape, how they line up against each other. Well, McKeever's 5 years younger, but has been in harder fights. The height and reach advantage of Dazzo Williams. McKeever made the weight at the second attempt. He's very tight at 9 stone, but could be physically stronger. McKeever been around for longer, more fights, more rounds, box. Neither a big, big puncher, but they both hit fairly sharply.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very warm welcome to the Bridge End Sports Centre here in the beautiful valleys of South Wales for tonight's championship boxing. Proudly presented for your entertainment, Barry Hearn of Ringside Boxing Promotions in association with Prince Promotions and Matchroom Sport. Present for you 12 rounds of boxing for the British Featherweight Championship and the coveted Lonsdale Belt. All sponsored by PokerMillion.com for a great game of online poker. And a very warm welcome to our viewers joining us live and exclusive here on Sky Sports. You've joined us for the very best ringside seat in the business. Well, it's Saturday fight night. All the officials have been appointed by the British Boxing Border Control Welsh Area Council here at ringside. Steward in charge and area representatives are Mr. John Rees and Mr. Brian Rennie. Inspectors Harry Carroll, Ron Pavitt, Kevin Fulfall, Mark Warner, and our three medical officers here, Dr. Davis, Dr. Jones, and Dr. Gary. Timekeeper at the bell is David Waters, and referee in charge of the action from Gillingham in Kent is Mr. Ian John Lewis. They are the officials. Here are the contestants. And firstly, the challenger, fighting out of the blue corner. He's wearing the black trunks, trimmed with white, weighed in championship weight of 9 stone. 25 record, 15 wins, 5 inside the scheduled distance, 4 losses and 1 draw. He's the former holder of the coveted Lonsdale belt. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome from Birkenhead, Lindlass, Jamie And now it's the turn of the champion fighting out of the red corner, wearing the white trunks trimmed with black. Weighing in at 8 stone, 13 pounds, 3 ounces, bringing an 11 fight record, 9 wins, 3 inside the scheduled distance, and just 2 defeats. He makes his first defense. Here's the reigning and defending British Featherweight Champion. Championship and the coveted Lonsdale belt.
I am the referee. I spoke to you both in the dressing rooms. Obey my command at all times. You both know the rules. Watch the heads, kick the punches up. When I shout break, you break clean. And remember, defend yourself at all times. Shake hands.
Plenty of greats have held this prestigious British 9 stone belt. Neither Dazzo Williams or Jamie McKeever can be compared to the legends like Kid Lewis and Jim Driscoll, Barry McGuigan. But in terms of sheer commitment, these two will give it their all. It's a genuine 50-50 pick'em which we hope will entertain, and should Glenn be fought at a pretty high tempo.
Well, the styles should just gel right to make it a very entertaining matchup. And there's a lot of pride at stake because McKeever, he wants that title back.
He has been out of the ring for 9 months. He fractured his left hand, Jamie McKeever, when losing the belt to Roy Rutherford. Literally fought almost with the right only throughout those 12 rounds. Will it hold up? Williams has the skills, the height, the reach, and the quick combinations, which he'll hope to pepper McKeever with. Both can be hurt, both have gone down, and both have a lot of ambition.
Well, early on, there looks a little bit of ring rust with McKeever, just struggling to get his timing right, get his shots on. Williams looks the sharper, he's landing with that long, solid jab and the right hand over the top.
This British belt, which has been a merry-go-round between these two and Roy Rutherford in the last few months. Can Dazzo Williams retain it? McKeever trying to close the distance down, but a little out of sorts and rhythm at the moment.
He's getting hit off Williams, who's picking his shots the better. Straight shots and hoops. And it's Williams who looks the more confident of the two at this early stage.
Yes, he does, standing tall, working fast. Looking for the right over the top, straight away. McKeever hunting the body, as often he does. Left hand from Williams.
And the left hook then from Williams and the right hand. He's the sharper, Adam.
Yeah, head movement, a problem at the moment for Jamie McKeever. Slow start from the Birkenhead man. Head's banging there. Ian John Lewis says, watch those. But it's intriguing and entertaining, this. Very experienced corner of Dazzo Williams, led by the former world Steve Robinson. Di Gardner in there as well. Good start from him.
It was certainly the better start from Dazzo Williams, who was sharper. It was more authority and got the punches on where it mattered.
Here's the second round. British featherweight title on the line. It's the black trunks of the 24-year-old Jamie McKeever from Birkenhead, looking to regain the title he briefly held. A slow start, but will he come on strong now and start backing up Williams and using his physical grit?
Well, he's got to get that chin down, McKeever, start rolling the shoulders, get a bit of rhythm, and most of all, start letting punches go.
Dazzo Williams, who was the English amateur featherweight champion. Really good feeling about this one.
Well, plenty of crowd noise. They're very excited, shouting for both their men.
Smile on the face of Jamie McKeever, who's trained for 7 solid weeks, but is having difficulty getting out of the way of some of these long arcing shots of Williams.
Williams just looking to throw those punches with some mean intention, really setting himself to let them go. He's trying with the body shot. That's where there's a bit of a weakness, we think, with McKeever.
Yes, well stopped in 3 by Craig Doherty. Body shots there. McKeever was down again against Roy Rutherford from the same sort of shot. Well, he's punching here at the Morgan McKeever. Williams hitting and then getting on his bike a little bit. Sharp start this from Dazzo Williams, who's really fighting like a champion, and there's already a swelling underneath the right eye of Jamie McKeever, who does mark up a fair bit.
Well, it's Williams, who looks like he's got the better game plan, spotting his fight. He's got more authority in his punches.
Little mark just by the left eye of Dazzo Williams, nothing much, but it's McKeever at the moment who's being busted up.
Yeah, McKeever blinking that right eye, that's obviously giving him some discomfort.
Just looks sharper all around at the moment, Dazzo Williams. McKeever needs something to get him into this fight.
Good defense from Williams, then just moves along the ropes and out of harm's way.
Another round for the British champion. Welcome back to Bridge End. The end swell already out from top cutsman Mick Williamson. They've got a good man in the corner of Jamie McKeever, but he just hasn't settled, Ben, has he?
No, he hasn't. I think mainly because Williams has started so well and beaten him to the punch. And he's just a little bit unsettled, McKeever.
Steve Robinson there just telling Dazzo Williams, you've got him. Keep it going. Keep it nice and solid. Here's the third round. This is when Jamie McKeever went down to Roy Rutherford, and the commentary man took the title and then was controversially beaten by Dazzo Williams in Belfast. Already a better display from Williams than I think we've seen before.
Well, can McKeever find the punch to get himself back in this fight? He is capable of that, but he needs to throw punches with authority.
Oh, slashing left hook from Dazzo Williams again on the bad swelling now underneath the right eye. Becoming a little grotesque that, and that's going to hamper Jamie McKeever surely.
Well, Williams has got the extra speed and at the moment just bewildering McKeever, who just can't get going.
I doubt whether it's the long time out of the ring or just the added confidence now that Dazzo Williams has brought. What's the weight factor really coming up to featherweight? Williams has been operating at super bantamweight as well. McKeever has to grind his body down. Good boxing this from Dazzo Williams.
Getting his hands up as well whenever McKeever tries to come forward and let his punches go. Then just guarding out with a jab and then away. Williams just making it so hard for McKeever to cut the ring off and get to him.
Defense very good from Dazzo Williams, keeping his elbows tucked in to block the body shots. Switching to southpaw. Some arrogant feel about the way he's doing this so far. Again, the left hook. He's too quick at the moment.
He is, it's the speed that's doing it. These slashing punches really marking up the face of McKeever. That left hook a little bit open gloves, but he's still getting through and he's still doing damage to that eye.
Dazzo Williams, but don't count out McKeever. He's been in wars before and he's got a great amount of bottle and heart.
Well, he looks like he's gonna need it, because really Williams is so determined.
It's a terrible start for Jamie McKeever as he attempts to regain the British 9-stone belt.
shaking their heads in the corner. Tony and John Carroll there. What do you tell him, Glenn?
Well, he's got to try and sharpen up. He needs to take the play away from Williams a little bit, but one of the first things you've got to tell him is just tighten your defence up, get your hands up. Taking far too many left hooks, and that's the big problem McKeever's got. He's very loose, very slack, and the punches getting through too much.
Here's the fourth round. Real intensity about this one. The 29-year-old from Hereford, only in fight number 12. He's learning the professional game, Dazzo Williams, as he goes along. Plenty of talent, and he's really starting to enjoy this. Against a ring rusty and slower Jamie McKeever than we've seen before.
A little better for McKeever as he tries to get closer.
Good left hook whipped in to the body of McKeever from Dazzo Williams.
But this is where McKeever needs to fight back. He's allowing Williams to have too many shots off. He's got to start throwing them as well.
He says he's improved twofold under the tutelage of Steve Robinson. Dazzo Williams, he travels miles to the Welsh Valleys to train, and he said he'll do anything to get off his fruit and veg stall, desperate to cling on to this British title and build upon it.
Showing good defence as well, getting the elbows in, stopping the body shots, the hands nice and tight around the chin, Williams.
Tries to force out that jab, really, McKeever. Doesn't look relaxed, there's no rhythmic feel to his work.
No, he looks very, very stiff, doesn't he, from the waist up. There's not a lot of movement, not a lot of looseness. The chin and head almost static target.
He's being comprehensively outboxed at the moment, Jamie McKeever. Williams growing.
He's really got the bit between his teeth, Adam. He's enjoying it. That's the difference. It's hard work in there for McKeever. It looks like he's really up for it, really enjoying what he's doing, Williams.
Absolutely. Against Roy Rutherford, it was a real tussle. Against Stephen Chinnock as well. Dazzo Williams didn't have everything his own way. It's now up to Jamie McKeever to try and reverse this and break the Williams rhythm.
Well, so far Williams has beaten him in every department. Again, McKeever throws in the mid-air.
Terrific start from Dazzo Williams, so fluent. Already slight panic stations over in the blue corner of Jamie McKeever. Bad swelling under the right eye. And look at the other corner, and the headshots landed 73-29 in Williams' favour. He looks like a newborn fighter since becoming champion. There's an air of authority, boxing brilliantly.
Well, that happens to a lot of fighters. You know, they get that lift and they realize what they can do, and they really bring them out of their shell and they become much better fighters. And that is what's happened to Dazzo Williams.
This is the 105th round of Jamie McKeever's professional career, which started when he was young at 18. And now he needs to really put some sort of dent into the Williams makeup, who continues to whip in these shots with ease.
Well, first 15 seconds, McKeever come out to make an impression and stamp his authority on it. But Williams just taking over again with big left hooks, catching McKeever at will. and the defence of McKeever is very, very poor. Get the chin down and the hands up.
Hands are down of McKeever, and often an open target. Look at the state of their faces, both of them. Compare that.
Well, the referee's going to watch that eye. That's a very bad swelling. That's going to hamper the vision. And he's not going to be able to see more of those left hooks. You can't see most of them because most of them are getting through anyhow.
Yes, Chris Eubank had a big swelling under his eye that curtailed his brave challenge at Carl Thompson a few years ago. Will that get worse and worse as the speed and accuracy tonight of Williams has impressed?
Williams playing with McKeever, at times switching to southpaw and just dangling that right glove in his face.
Checkered career, Jamie McKeever. He's had his ups and downs and wars with journeyman fighters, really, like Sebastian Hart. He's had to dig deep to come through those, but maybe he had his great night in Liverpool when he won the British title. And it all seems very hard for him in there tonight.
Williams still has to watch their heads, because they bang together now and again, and it'd be a shame when he's boxing this well for him to pick up a cut. That's a grotesque swelling that's coming up under the eye of Jamie McKeever.
Yeah, shutting that right eye. And he's not seeing some of these left hooks, I don't think. I wonder if the Carrolls are having a look at Jamie McKeever. A little bit more ominously. Because nothing from the first bell has gone right for him.
Next week on Saturday Fight Night, we're in Glasgow for the former British and now WBO World Featherweight Champion Scott Harrison's defence of his crown. New opponent, Walter Estrada of Colombia. That's live from Glasgow next Saturday night at 8 on Sky Sports 1. British featherweight title in the fine tradition tonight.
Absolutely, Paul. But at the moment it is one-way traffic. It's all Dazzo Williams. How much has come on from winning the British nine stone belt? What can Jamie McKeever do? Is there anything? Is that eye too bad? It is swollen up horribly. Mick Williamson has been working on it round after round, and it must be getting so hard for him in there, especially vision-wise.
Well, also he's got to be running out of fire, and he's been hit at will, McKeever, and you know, he's trying hard, missing with a lot of punches, but how much can he take of this before the will runs out?
The left hand does seem to have held up, the one he fractured, Jamie McKeever. He put an operation on standby so he could have this chance. But styles make fights, and at the moment, Dazzo Williams has everything to deal with Jamie McKeever. Defence has been excellent from Williams.
It's been good. McKeever just trying to pick it up a little bit. Williams chucks his arms by his side and then comes out throwing a lot more punches. It's his determination. I'm impressed with that. And, you know, he really means it. He wants it.
Right hand from McKeever. Rare success. This was the round that he won the British title against Tony Mulholland. And some great fights, Jamie McKeever, but they have been hard. Whoa, right hand again from Dazzo Williams, who doesn't hit terribly hard, but stings, I'm sure.
Boxing behind the southpaw jab, not letting that punch, but it's enough to confuse McKeever and set him up for something different.
Getting a bit closer, Jamie McKeever. Getting some applause from the he grind Williams down? Is there any way?
Well, he's trying that bit hard again. A little bit more success in this round, McKeever. Still the better work. Late down of a cut from Williams.
Juicy looking shot from Williams, who follows it up with a tip-tap body shot combination. McKeever digs in. He has heart, the Birkenhead man, and he will not give up until it is really all over for him. All calm and composed in Williams' corner.
We're getting there.
Trying to encourage him.
There's the good defence from McKeever. The odd one getting through as McKeever had a bit better round. But Williams just keeps coming out of that defence with the better punches. Even if he has to take one or two, he still comes back firing with a meatier, sharper, better looking punches.
That eye almost shut. Punches. Nearly double there for Dazzo Williams as we enter the second half. Williams, the British champion in his first defence. Jamie McKeever hoping to regain the title, but he's a mile behind, surely, on Ian John Lewis's card. It's been a traumatic one, really, for Jamie McKeever. But Williams does occasionally go through lapses in the middle round. Stephen Chinook gave him a hard one at about this sort of time. So will that give McKeever hope?
Well, he's still got to keep this sort of punch rate up, Williams. He can't afford to slacken. McKeever's got about every member of the Avenue pub in Birkenhead screaming for him. They're on the feet, trying to push him on. That's his local.
Yeah, there's about 60 or 70 fans alongside us making an unbelievable racket. Tremendous atmosphere here at Bridge End. They're willing their man on, but Williams at the moment will not be denied. What do you think of this switch to southpaw?
Well, it's worked. It hasn't been anything of a special shot. He's done it every now and again. I don't think he'll get away with it with every fighter he's in with, but it's worked well against McKeever. He just does that when he wants to buy a little bit of time, get on his bike. He switches to southpaw and moves out of the way.
He's been smiling almost throughout this contest, Dazzo Williams. Doesn't want all that good work to go out of the window with something careless. Because while McKeever's still there, he's got that outside chance of turning things around.
Well, he's on his bike now, and Williams is starting to drop his hands as he moves around. That could be a problem for him if McKeever catches him solid. But I think this, what we're seeing, is the mark of confidence. You know, he thinks he can play with McKeever. Let's hope that's not his undoing after such good work.
I'm sure a sensible, level-headed man like Steve Robinson in the corner will be doing everything possible to tell his man not to get careless. Fox quite beautifully at times, but McKeever still looks fairly strong and is at least getting closer with those hooks. Well, let's join Ed, who's got the former British champion Roy Rutherford with him.
Well, Roy, are you surprised at how dominant Williams is?
Oh, I'm very surprised about the dominance, what he's doing there, but I just think that Jay McKeever is struggling at the weight. definitely. He just hasn't got the same speed, he hasn't got the same determination, going in there, throwing his shots. It just isn't the same. Compared to when I was fighting him as well. I mean, I fought both the guys, but I really fought him a lot more close than this. But I think, good old Dazzo Williams is up in the head and gives me a good chance to get my rematch with him, you know what I mean?
Can McKeever do anything to get back into this fight?
I can't really see it because he just hasn't got the energy down there, you know? He just seems so weak. You know, he's hitting everything he wished to do, so I wish him the best anyway, but it just seems like a really one-sided fight.
Thank you, Roy. No energy, weak at the weight, says Roy Rutherford. It's pretty much been that, it looks like, but just switched off a touch Dazzo Williams in that last round, and will that give McKeever some sort of confidence?
Well, it might. I thought that was McKeever's best round. Williams just moved and ran and poked out that jab, which wasn't really a scoring southpaw jab, and that was the first round I actually give to McKeever. So to me, he might find it a little way in now if Williams is just starting to tire.
Oh, left hand from Dazzo Williams just rocked McKeever momentarily. I'm sure Roy Rutherford would love his revenge on Dazzo Williams. He outboxed Jamie McKeever and thought he got the decision over the Hereford fighter as well. Deserves his chance, doesn't he, again?
Well, I'm sure he'll get it. But Williams just has to finish this job off and do it in style.
Still working the body and flicking between the southpaw and orthodox stance, Dazzo Williams, but slightly less coming from him.
He's looked for the body shot, Williams. Hasn't really landed that flush. I think he wishes he could get a left hook into the body of McKeever, who again is just starting to build up and getting through some decent punches.
Yeah, right hand picked through about 15 seconds ago, and the wry smile on Williams' face was a slightly different one than it has been through much of the fight.
It's just a sense Williams losing a little of his sharpness as he starts to tire. This is allowing McKeever to get that bit closer and to connect with more shots.
He's only got five stoppage wins on the slate, Jamie McKeever. Not a thunderous puncher by any stretch of the imagination, but can he wear Williams down?
And McKeever, the added problem of looking through that right eye, which is almost closed shut, just a little slit to see his opponent through.
Yes, fighting through much of this with one eye, like he did with one arm against Roy Rutherford. Not ideal.
Not as accurate anymore, Williams, but still getting through with plenty punches.
Blocked that one well, McKeever. But he can't see the left hooks coming to his head. That's the problem. But it's a really good British nine-stone division at the moment. We've got the two at world level, Scott Harrison defending next weekend, and Michael Brody has the rematch against Injin Chi. Nicky Cook going for European honours. And then there's sort of four or five of them, including Stephen Foster, who became English champion last week, who could all fight each other and entertain us for the next couple of years.
Well, it's an interesting division, isn't it? This featherweight one at British level, and there's plenty of good matches out there. And this one is turning out as we thought it, very exciting, with McKeever just making a little more impression. Williams still the boss.
Plenty of punches have been thrown. The more accurate work has come from Dazzo Williams, who looks on course to retain his British featherweight title in the white shorts. Called Dazzo, real name Darren Williams, but there was a pro under that name already when he turned goes by Dazzo. Brought up in London, lives in Hereford now, and got a big fan base in Wales. McKeever, who hasn't really moved his upper body quite well enough, looked terribly stiff early on and rusty. And yeah. Now that left hook just keeps getting him.
Adam, that head's been pretty much held in the same place all the time. And Williams has found it pretty easy to tee shots off, especially the left.
Picked up his work again. Dazzo Williams confusing McKeever with the jabs with both hands from both stances. What's a decent right over the top from McKeever, who's still in this, and maybe you wouldn't have thought that after the first five rounds.
Just misses with a wild punch, Williams. Still trying to get that left hook to the body on, but still ineffective, still not getting it right in there, Williams.
Tell you something, Jamie McKeever is never in a dull fight. He really is a real tough customer who just won't give up.
Well, he's been in a lot of tough fights, but he's only 24. You don't want to be in that many when you're that age, dear. It doesn't bode well for a long career.
I think they thought when he lost to John Kelly and was knocked out by Craig Doherty, he may not go anywhere near a British title, but credit to him, he turned his career around. But he's got to find something different here if he's going to regain the title he had.
Well, he keeps threatening McKeever, but it's classy. Nice work from Williams, who switches, moves around, gives him the angles, then comes back with the punches. Maybe not a lot in them, but they're effective and they're scoring.
Boxing like a champion, Dazzo Williams. And look at the jabs landed, almost double there from the southpaw and orthodox. Both hands.
Yep, there's the one with the southpaw stance with the right hand. Just moving away from the left hook of McKeever. Just flicks it out, but it's enough to keep McKeever off balance and unsettled. And to set McKeever up for better punches, which Williams keeps throwing in. There's a left hook counter.
There's Glenn's card. 7-up for Dazzo Williams. Jamie McKeever surely needs a knockout now. He's got 9 minutes to find it. He hasn't really been able to see much out of the right eye since the second round of this fight. Dazzo Williams has used his boxing skills and brain and his newfound confidence as the champion to be winning this and winning this well.
Well, a little charge there from McKeever, who's starting to get frustrated at his lack of success.
As you said, Glenn, he gives us flashes, but Williams tucks up and seems to weather the storm each and every time.
Well, he's got to keep trying. He's got to try and find a gap in the defense. He's got to try and get a shot on that will make an impression, something that could change this fight around.
Those Birkenhead faithful right by us are winning him on, but that's a lovely uppercut. And a following body shot from Dazzo Williams.
What a nice little touch of variety there from Williams.
Oh, he's so brave, McKeever. But is he just too brave for his own good sometimes? Outclassed here by Williams.
McKeever gets through with a left hook to the body and head.
Once again, the fast whipping accuracy from Williams was the eye catcher. As McKeever tries to pile on the pressure. Look at him, really gritting his teeth. But is it having any effect?
Well, it's not. The guard is very good. He tucks up tightly, then comes out with a barrage of punches to take the eye and say, that's how it should be done.
We thought this would be pitched at a high tempo. It has indeed. Real intensity, electricity in that ring. They may not be world beaters, these two, but they are giving it their all, as we knew they would.
The Birkenhead fans roar when McKeever has some success, but it only spurs Williams on more to come back with better punches.
For much of this, he's fought with an air. Dazzo Williams playing with Jamie McKeever, but McKeever keeps trying to thrust those body shots in. This and look at that, over 1,000 punches thrown at this stage in the fight, the end of the 10th round. Congratulations to both men.
Well, good fight to watch, entertaining, and look at this, the variety he shows here was tremendous. Switching the punches around the right hand side, up the middle, and then one with the left. McKeever, dogged determination, keeps on trying to get through, keeps forcing Williams back to the ropes and pushing away, but tucking up well, Williams.
Jamie McKeever has tried everything he knows, but Dazzo Williams has been a step ahead all the way. Can you believe he's only won 9 professional fights until this point, Williams?
No, boxing with a new confidence of a mature professional. Now he's won the British featherweight title.
He's got under 6 minutes to stay cool, keep that defense tight, keep McKeever at bay, and ease his way home, because this is the dangerous part. All the good work's done, but he continues to produce more. Right hook to the body, and left hook again to that problematic eye from Dazzo Williams. Still retaining the speed this late on in the fight, as McKeever valiantly tries to fight back.
Well, he's putting on a very good show, Dazzo Williams. Much better than his last fight in winning this title. Really has been the making of him, Adam.
Yes, the Irish fans and the King's Hall booed the decision when he beat Roy Rutherford. I don't think the Welsh fans and even the Birkenhead people will appreciate Dazzo Williams should he stay on course and retain the title. He's boxed extremely well, beyond all expectations. And look how relaxed he is in there as he peppers McKeever again.
He's obviously worked very hard. He's done his preparation, Williams. He's wanted to make an impression in this fight, and he's certainly doing that. Walked under one there from McKeever, though.
But he comes back with 5-6. Rocking to the head of McKeever, who's got blood from the nose swellings on his face, and yet still he fights through the pain.
But he just doesn't have the answers, does he? Can't find a way in, can't find a punch to make a dent.
He almost did there, slipped on the advertising hoarding, Dazzo Williams, and Ian John Lewis obviously calls no knockdown.
Yeah, just got the feet tangled a little bit there, trying to move away from McKeever. McKeever's worked well in this round, some good shots inside.
Work rate from Jamie McKeever, but accuracy again from Dazzo Williams. Well, there, pleased as pie in that corner. As the punches landed, you see, Williams has got through with far more, and they've been quality, haven't they, Glenn?
Yep, he's really relaxed, throwing the shots. And we can expect a good finish. He just dropped off the pace a little bit in that round. Still got through some good shots, allowed McKeever to work him inside. But at times, some very good combinations. Shame he hasn't got that big of a dig, because that would certainly add to the repertoire, wouldn't it, if you had that?
Glenn has, unofficially, Dazzo Williams 7-up. McKeever needs a knockout. May have won a couple of rounds on the card, Jamie McKeever, for sheer relentless, as he calls himself, work rate. But the firepower hasn't been there. And Williams has tucked up nicely, enjoyed boxing as a British champion, and is a round away from keeping hold of that prestigious Lonsdale belt.
Well, it looks like he wants to finish the show. Dazzo Williams, good punches going in, got the sharpness and the bounce of a man who knows he's close to the finish.
Tony and John Carroll look very, very dejected men in Jamie McKeever's corner, but they can be proud of their fighter, because he's been out of the ring for a long time. And he's had that bad, bad swelling from so early on in this fight, but he's kept going and kept trying.
Well, he's got to hand it to McKeever for that. He's doggedly kept at his job, still is in the last round, only to be caught with a crunching left hook from Williams.
We asked the question whether Dazzo Williams was a lucky British champion. Maybe he was winning it. No luck about what he's done tonight. He's produced a display of skills that make him a worthy title holder.
McKeever trying to pump the arms inside the guard of Williams. But it's a side leg left hook that Williams comes out with.
Tries to throw those arms again, McKeever. How tired must they be? So many punches in this 12-round affair, which has intrigued the crowd here, and I hope all of you watching on television too.
Well, it has been a cracking contest. McKeever having success in this last round. He's trying to get the punches going. Should have done this a bit earlier.
Hands just dropped there, and Williams senses that. McKeever beckons him in. There must be so much respect in that ring between the two. But once again, it's Dazzo Williams that comes out on top after the exchanges. Story of the fight.
Yeah, Williams always throwing the flashier, more eye-catching punches. McKeever trying to get through, trying to force forward. But has he left it all too late? He has.
He's fought his heart out, Jamie McKeever, but it's a wonderful British featherweight title defence by Dazzo Williams. Look at the appreciation all round this Bridgend crowd who have enjoyed every minute of that 36 minutes. A hug between the two. Good fighters. Plenty of respect. And a wonderful performance from Dazzo Williams. How much has he come on since becoming champion?
Well, it tends to do that to you. You win a British title, it's the biggest thing you can imagine. The belt that everybody wants. And he's won it. It's also a step to bigger money and some big fights. And he's really come on from that and proved it in a wonderful display here against Jamie McKeever.
Look how many punches thrown. What's that about? 1,300. And he landed, but the success for Dazzo Williams almost through the entire fight. Never let McKeever into it.
He was much more accurate. McKeever kept working away, but it was the accuracy that told in the end.
Well done to Dazzo Williams.
Ladies and gentlemen, the referee has asked me to ask you to show your appreciation for 12 of the most wonderful rounds of boxing. Ladies and gentlemen, the referee pointed out that during the 12 rounds he never had to say break once. I think we witnessed the fight of the year. Ladies and gentlemen, the referee scorecard reads: McKeever 113, Williams 116, the winner, and still the British featherweight champion from Hereford, Dazzo Williams.
7-4 with one even, maybe a bit close on the card, but Williams is night, no doubt about that.
It might take a good man to separate that belt from Dazzo Williams. Tremendous action here. Both men can be proud of themselves. That will be scant consolation to the loser, McKeever, of course, but both can be proud of themselves. Lots more fine action to come here in Bridgend tonight. Live, young Welsh heavyweight hope, Scott Gammer against James Zickich. That's coming live shortly. And keep an eye out as well for a memorable lightweight fight here tonight between Gary Hibbert and Dean Phillips back on the scene. Spencer Oliver, you were looking forward to it. Did it live up to your expectations tonight?
Absolutely, and even more. I mean, tremendous contest. We knew both come forward fighters. It was always going to be exciting, and they're both, you know, tremendous respect and hats off to them both. Both fought their hearts out. Right result, but tremendous contest.
Well, they're on their way out to join Adam Smith here, both of them, and in the best traditions of this British featherweight title, the best traditions of British boxing, the best traditions of the sport, they're going to sit side by side and tell Adam how it was in there.
Fabulous fight. Congratulations to both of you for giving us such an intense encounter. Dazzo, first of all, you box with a new air of authority as champion, it seemed to us tonight.
Yeah, it's made me realise like I got to work hard for this. I mean, it's hard enough to get it, and it's even harder to keep it. And it's hard. And I knew McKeever, like, he's a tough lad. And I've seen tapes from him, and I knew he was. It's his last crack at the whip, and I knew he was going to go for it.
And you were flowing though with your shots and your accuracy.
Yeah, I knew McKeever's a come forward, strong, gritty fighter. He's got a lot of bags of art. Like, I mean, I knew my boxing skill would be better of it. I couldn't get involved too much because I know he can stand there and he can trade. So I had to use my boxing ability.
Jamie McKeever, you always entertain us. You're never in a dull fight, but you had a difficult start with the eye and you looked slow getting going.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, the weight, I had to get a bit of weight off at the last minute. Don't know whether it's, you know, I'm growing out of the featherweight division a bit. It's a bit hard to make it now, but my hat goes off to that Dazzo. He boxed a great fight. You know, he raised the pace and that. He boxed very well and, you know, he come on leaps and bounds since his last performances. He boxed very well and it took me out top two.
Tell me something, what makes you in rounds 10, 11 and 12 of fights like that still go forward with your relentlessness?
Something clinking in the corner, I tell you.
I don't know, I've got a good heart. I don't know if everyone will agree. I've got just a fighter's heart, you know. I never give up, but no. And I've got the will to win, but tonight he was the better man and I take my hat off to him. He's a nice man and he deserves everything he gets.
Great to have that respect. Dazzo, you feel you've come on from this and can go on to bigger and better things. You've retained the title in this merry-go-round of late.
I know, seems to be a bit of a jinx on it, and I've been having thoughts about it all the time, and I thought, oh, I don't need it tonight, it's a jinx on this belt. But I've broken the spell and I hope to keep it like that.
You threw over 1,300 punches, a cracking fight. Congratulations to both of you.
Can I just... Yeah.